from Hilltop.
Where she is.
Hot Springs.
Down by you. Well, you're kind of. Yeah, no, you're right. Yeah, you're right. You're in the hot spot. I can sense him. Might want to close the tap off. Yeah, it's really hot. Moon high in a cold black sky.
Oh, man. That's so nice.
Illuminates my bed.
The trail to Cottonwood Pass.
Here we are on our first leg of our journey, looking back at Horseshoe Meadow. Around that further bend is where we started, at Horseshoe Meadow Campground. As I come across, I'm picking up a stranger. This is John Collins, looking fit as ever. We're about halfway on our first leg, I'm thinking. Pretty close, I think. But we got a ways to go yet, and we're surviving so far.
Well, we've made it to the top of Cottonwood Pass. The scenery is gorgeous. Headed down in that direction.
Well, some predict the rapture.
Day one campsite, Chicken Spring Lake. 11,000 feet.
The chosen ones will pack their bags for
12,000 feet peaks around us. Our tent site. Our first campsite, and it's hailing. Rock Creek, day two. Beautiful sky, beautiful mountains. Good. Was this for that Japanese group?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Love stuff.
We're heading to Yosemite.
Oh, yeah, nice.
Yeah.
Have a good trip, guys.
Thanks. Yeah. This is the trail from Rock Creek. Gorgeous, beautiful blue sky. Russ is hanging in there like a trooper. The trees are just awesome here. This is what the trail's like.
Here's our camp set up at Rock Creek. There goes John going by. He's having a heck of a time. We just completed a 9.4 mile walk or hike from Chicken Spring Lake. And we're headed down to Timber Lake tomorrow, just before Crabtree Junction. We actually saw a couple of deer in the back of the campsite there, a little fawn and a doe earlier, but we didn't have our cell phones available, so we couldn't take a picture. Have a good night.
We're almost to the meadow, Crabtree Meadow, which is right down there. And the pass to Whitney is up there. It's a beautiful day. Making good time.
Here we are on our way to Guitar Lake. The weather's beautiful. You look up, still don't know the name of these trees, but blue sky. That's the trail behind us. John, he's up ahead of me. Doesn't even know I stopped, but he's up the trail there a ways. The trail that we're hiking right now. We're about, I'd say, close to 4 miles into our hike to Guitar Lake. From there, we're going to be climbing Mount Whitney tomorrow. If it's anything like today, it's going to be beautiful.
Lake. On our way to Guitar Lake, which is about another mile from here. It's getting rough, we're tired, but we'll make it. We made it to Guitar Lake. It's a hard 9.4 miles. Tomorrow, we head up to Whitney with a day pack. 5 miles from here and 5 miles back. Gonna take some ibuprofen tonight. It's Friday morning, and we're gonna ascend Mount Whitney today. This is Guitar Lake. It's a beautiful sunny morning. Blue skies. Camp's right over there. There's Russ. Feet. At 13,000 feet. 2,500 to go. Way to Whitney, looking down at Lone Pine. It's Rusty.
Okay, we're at 14,000 feet. There's John. We got about 505 feet to go, and just beyond him is Mount Whitney. I'm coasting around here, taking in the scenery. We've had to use a few puffs of O2. It's really helped out. It gives us a little bit of a boost. Makes us feel like 20 years younger, actually. But you can see down below the lakes. There's Guitar Lake way down there. A little bit of snow here and there. But we're enjoying this. You just can't imagine what it's like.
Her wounds. Oceans.
Up of Mount Whitney. Down into Lone Pine.
We have a beautiful mother. Her teeth, the white stones at the edge of the water. The summer grasses, her plentiful hair. We have a beautiful mother. Her green lap. Brown embrace eternal. Her blue body, everything we know.
It's Saturday morning, August 27th. We're at Timberland Lake, heading towards Tyndall Creek. Mostly downhill today, which is great. Beautiful little lake here. With lots of trout.
Here we are, showing you a little panoramic view. We're kind of right over Wallace Creek at this point. Maybe about another half mile to go. We're doing okay. We're on the march. We just met a big group of Korean gentlemen that are packing very light. They must have a commercial packing business taking their equipment. Come spinning around there. There's a trail we're going to be going down. There's John sitting on a big old log, taking a break.
Yeah.
We finally made it to Tyndall Creek. It was a long haul today, 10.4 miles. This is Tyndall Creek here, as you can see. We're really tired today. Off in the distance is just unbelievable peaks. You go right up like so over Tyndall Creek, and you can see the bright blue sky. And it's about 6:30 right now. We're going to be setting up camp. I got some sore shoulders. I'm a heavy pack, but we're managing okay. Good night.
Horn Plateau. We were thinking of camping here, but I guess it gets pretty windy. There's no trees. It's gorgeous. Russ likes to call this Buffalo Plateau. On the way to Forster Pass. Beautiful sunny day. Day 6. And you can get a glimpse of Whitney right there in the middle. This is looking sharp as ever.
We have such a beautiful mother. Sing to the beautiful mother.
We're here at the beginning of Forster Pass. This is where we came from. It's a nice lake here. And we are going up this gorge to the top of Forster Pass.
Top of Forster Pass.
Thank you.
This is where we went for a swim on day 7. Right into that little pool. Some beautiful fish in there. It was awesome.
There goes John. Found a nice pool here in the river. First dip we've taken in a while. He's looking good. Yeah. Good job.
It's Russ taking a dive.
Woo!
Beautiful panorama of the countryside here.
Got him.
We're at day 9, hiking up out of Onion Valley. We're about halfway up to Kearsarge Pass. Just spotted this beautiful mountain lake. I thought I'd take a picture of this, a video. It's beautiful. Scan up here on the mountainside. You can see some of the snow. Back over. We're both doing okay. You know, some aches and pains, but it was good to get a fresh break yesterday down in Independence and Lone Pine.
Top of Kearsarge Pass. Russ swimming in Bullfrog Lake. The water's a little cold, but it's so refreshing. It's an awesome lake.
There's John in Bullfrog Lake. He doesn't look like a bullfrog to me, but he's enjoying the fresh water. It's a little cooler than Kearsarge Lake that we went into the other day. This is a view of the whole lake. It's really pretty. It's awesome. The colors are spectacular. Looking up overhead, you can see some of the mountains in the background. And up overhead, we're on day 9. Day 10, It's about 4:45 in the morning. I got up early. Birds were chirping and carrying on above my tent, so I figured I'd come out here and give you a view of the scenery. This is looking up and up and up. This is over our campsite. It's quite spectacular. I'd like to be able to see a mountain sheep, but I don't think that's going to be impossible this morning. I don't know why, but we're coming down like so. And that little clump of trees right there is where our campsite is. John's not up yet. If you look up this way, you'll see that's where we're headed today, through Glen Pass, down through Arrowhead Lake. Right up in that direction, right there. I can get my finger out of the way. Yeah, right in there. And it'll be Arrowhead Lake to Marjorie Lake. This is day 10.
Top of Glen Pass. Down at Ray Lakes. A lot of people up here. Skinny little top. There's a marmot. There's the lake, that's where we came up.
Upper Ray Lake, see that little island there? We're on day 10. We had a long downhill from Glen Pass this morning. Seems like we've been going down forever. But this is an unbelievable setting here. We're both doing well. We're gonna proceed down Ray Lakes. I'm gonna give you a little scan up above. Up over Ray Lake, Upper Ray Lake. Beautiful blue sky every day.
The Ray Lake, just the colors are just so beautiful. The water crystal clear, little island, the mountains. Blue sky. It's just unbelievable. There's hardly any words you can say to describe it.
We're at Arrowhead Lake. Beautiful lake. Can't get over this weather. We just came down from Lower Ray Lake. Took a nice refreshing swim. We took some still shots there. So we're heading on down. Oh, there's a marmot. He continues to follow me.
Here comes Russ, walking across the bridge. It's pretty wobbly. It's pretty cool. Suspension bridge.
Beautiful Woods Creek. Another beautiful blue sky day.
Yeah, we're going to be going up over that tomorrow morning on day 13. Swing around here. Here's the trail ahead of us. A little bit more of a cloudy day than what we've had in the past. Dipping down, you can see our campsites. There, swing over. There's John's tent. Back up and over to the peaks, down like so, and right there is where we're getting our water source for this, for today and tomorrow. Swing up and around like so, you can see the clouds. But we're both doing fine, tired and sore, but we're doing fine. We made it. That was a long, hard day. Top of Pinchup Pass. Right down there, that second lake is Lake Marjorie, where we're gonna spend the night. And it's just gorgeous. And that's where we came from, way down in one of those valleys. 7 miles uphill. Saturday morning, day 12. And we're headed to Mather Pass. It's right around that bend. Another beautiful morning. What's with these clouds? Mather Pass, looking back the way we came up. We just camped by third lake down. Lake Marjorie is way over there. We were there the day before. Pass. We broke camp around 9:30 this morning. We're up here now looking down at Upper and Lower Palisade Lakes, in which we're headed today, hoping to get around the bend, get down near Deer Meadow somewhere. But you can see this panoramic view. You know, still spots of snow from last year. That'll never melt. As I scope around here, I don't lose my balance. Looking up to this little peak off to my left and coming back down. You can see a couple of hikers right here. They're going the way we came. I'm kind of approaching John. John's taking a picture on the other side. And I keep spanning, scoping around here. A little windy at the top. We had frost this morning, about about 31 degrees, 30 degrees.
Swimming hole number 6. Lower Palestine Lake. Just gorgeous. Yeah, the water's just awesome. We had a great time. Water goes off that way. Mountains around. All right. There goes Russ down the trail in this canyon. Typical type of trail, switchbacks.
Trails to you until we meet again. Da 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 da. We're on the trail again. Just left Deer Meadow 45 minutes ago or so, getting another late start, but us old folks, we have to take our time about things if we want to go the distance. Now, we're headed to Peace Meadow. We're going to try to set up for Muir Pass for tomorrow so we can get a good start on that pass. I just want to let you know what kind of trail we're on right now. It's really, really nice. No hills, just kind of flat, little ups and downs. Catch you later. We just approached this meadow. It's a no-name meadow, but it's unbelievably beautifully beautiful. Can you see that deer way up in the distance, the other side of the water? Beautiful. Scanning the whole meadow as we're going. We're going to be going out and by here. Just awesome. Scan up and over.
Wicked awesome.
Wicked awesome, John says. Wow.
Beautiful morning, beautiful trail here, hiking through the woods, heading towards Muir Pass. It's just awesome. Meadows everywhere, through there, big mountains, blue sky. It's just another unbelievable day.
In the morning, day 15, John just getting out of his cubbyhole. Sun's not quite yet up yet. It's slowly, you can see this coming down from the mountaintop. It's about 5:45 in the morning. It's pretty cold right now. It's about 34 degrees. So we're getting ready to do Muir Pass this morning. 3.2 miles up to the top, which is somewhere off in that direction. I'm not quite sure where that is. 12,100 feet.
Sing praise, sing praise.
are at Helen Lake on our way to Muir Pass. It's a huge lake. Colors are fantastic. Like Russ said, you could water ski on this lake. I've been searching for a cloud, can't find one.
Here we are on day 15, right at the top of Muir Pass. It wasn't a bad climb at all. Wanda Lake down there in the distance. We're going to be going between those two lakes and around to the left, head toward Evolution Lake. We still got this plenty of snow up here from last winter. See, coming around here, like there, there's John hanging out. Here's your hut that we just visited with a gentleman inside for 10-15 minutes. He was from Minnesota. You can see the just rich blue sky. I mean, we've been having this kind of sky for days and days. So that's what we're at right now, and we got about 6 miles to go to get to our next campsite, Evolution.
What's your horse's name?
Rye. Yeah.
We're on our way to North Evolution Lake. This is Sapphire Lake. Just beautiful. We took our seventh swim right here today. Water temperature was excellent. Russie. It's just gorgeous. It was really fun. All right, this is where we decided to camp for the night. We got a beautiful spot next to a river that's flowing over the mountainside here. And this is the view we get from our campsite. Down to the valley, Evolution Valley below. This is the waterfall by our campsite. Goes down over the ledge. These are the mountains around. We should have a nice sunset tonight. The valley below. That's where we're headed tomorrow, down in this valley.
Day 16. We're just coming down. We just left North Evolution Lake where we camped last night. And this is McClure Meadow. Beautiful spot. We're both doing well. Another bright sunny day, bright blue sky. It's just unbelievable, the weather we've been getting. So serene right here, just can't believe it. Thought we'd see some wildlife, but we haven't. We saw 3 deer earlier.
Swimming hole number 8.
Oh.
It was cold. We're on a bridge going across the San Joaquin River. I believe it's the San Joaquin. Sheldon Pass. These are Marie Lakes down below. We'll be heading down to the left of those lakes. Day 18, as Russ just said. Gorgeous weather again. 17 days in a row, sunshine. There he is, all muscular. Another great day. Can't say it enough. Swimming hole number 9. We're going in. Another beautiful day.
Day 19, we just left Bear Creek campground area. We're now probably 3/4 mile on our hike. We're headed to Vermilion Resort, where we're going to spend our 0 day. We didn't spend it at MTR because we needed reservations. We're both doing well, enjoying the scenery. I mean, this is, I don't know how many days in a row of blue sky, like 18 maybe or so. Oh, catch you later.
Our first stormy day is our 0 day here at Vermilion. Getting some lightning and thunder over here. This is Lake Edison. We're gonna catch a boat ride to the other end tomorrow. Hopefully it'll be enough. This will pass. Day 21. We're on top of Silver Pass. We came from BVR this morning. And we're headed towards Squaw Lake. And we still gotta go up and over this little hill here. And it's a cloudier day than normal. We're hoping it doesn't turn into rain at some point.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. We've just come down over Silver Pass. This is the other side, looking down at Papoose Lake, Chief Lake. And over that next ridge, I think, is Squaw Lake, where we're going to be camping for the night. I'm going to scan up and over and around. Coming down here into Chief Lake. And going up and around, this is the way we came. And that's about it for right now. Awesome, a lot of wind today.
This is day 22. We're heading towards Tully Hole and then up a little climb, then we're heading towards Purple Lake. Beautiful river right here. There's Russ. Say hi, Russ.
Hello.
And we're coming around. A little cloudy today. We've heard that it's gonna pass and it'll be sunny for the next week, so we're hoping. On our way to Purple Lake, we're taking some switchbacks up here, coming from the valley below, about 1,000 feet up on our hike today. Beautiful valley. Gorgeous mountains. Good morning. Day 23. We're heading out of Purple Lake. Clear blue sky today. And we're heading to Upper Crater Meadow, 9.5 miles away. And this is our trail out. This morning, Russ realized he left his phone back at camp. So we're taking a little break here. Pack's off. And Russ went that way. All right. Gorgeous day again, another gorgeous.
Jasmine breeze, like incense in my hair. Moon high.
Here we are on the trail, and we just opened up to an expanse. Had to take a little short video. So gorgeous. This is our trail. We're still above 10,000 feet. Awesome. Wicked awesome.
Life can make you bigger.
Walking down the trail to Red's Meadow. Beautiful trail. I'm staying a little behind Russ so that I don't breathe his dust. It's gorgeous trails. Walking through an old fire area on the way to Red's. Yep, everything's coming back slowly. Day 25, heading out from Red's Meadow Resort, and right across from Devil's Post Pile National Monument. See if I can zoom in. Might see the pillars right across the way. Right in there. It's another glorious, beautiful sunny day. We came across that burned out field yesterday, mountainside, and we're heading to Rosalie Lake today. Day 26, on the trail heading to Thousand Island Lake. Still snow up in the passes. We're heading up this way. Picture of Shadow Lake down below. Come around. Nice little valley down here up to the peaks. I'm going through this pass over here. There's Russ taking it all in. Another gorgeous blue sky. Awesome day. Back to the lake. This is Garnet Lake with Mount Banner in the background. Gorgeous. Day 27. Looks like the smoke from the fire has filled the valley next to us. And we'll be heading north of that. Heading over Donahue Pass today. Beautiful, calm morning. Mount Banner, Mount Ritter, and the Minuet Mountains to the far right. Gorgeous morning.
Looking up at Lyell Glacier. We're hoping to get up there on this trip, but we just didn't give ourselves enough days. But beautiful. Mount McClure is over on the other side. I'm scanning around here, these peaks. It's a little bit on the kind of like foggy side. It's from smoke from a forest fire back. Down in the valley. That's where we're eventually headed to Army. I'm going to meet John's sister there tomorrow. This is day 28. We're just leaving camp. We camped here. We're calling this Lyell Meadow. You can see it's another beautiful day. We're headed to Tuolumne today to pick up Barbara, John's sister. You can see up here Lyell Glacier.
Looks like the smoke is gone.
Yeah, the smoke has disappeared from that forest fire. So we're on our way.
Day 29 on the trail. This is Cathedral Peak. Nice blue sky. We're on our way to Sunrise High Sierra Camp. And today we have Barbara with us.
Woo-hoo!
And Russell. Yeah, it's gonna be nice. Upper Cathedral Lake. There's Barb, who just filtered water with her unit. And there's Russ, who's happier than a clam. And this is Upper Cathedral Lake. A few clouds moved in today.
There, we're looking at Old Man of the Mountains in the Sierra Nevadas. Day 29. Really kind of funny looking, but he's got quite a nose on him. We're headed to High Sierra Camp. We're probably about 2 miles away. I'm camping for the night. Here we are, day 30. Unbelievable. We're at High Sierra Camp, just leaving. You can see the storm clouds moving around. it's starting to rain now. I'm glad we got our ponchos on our packs. Looking around here, great meadow. Saw a coyote. There's Mr. Coyote. There's Mrs. Coyote.
Picture of the High Sierra.
We have a beautiful mother. Her hills of buffaloes.
Her view buffaloes on the way hills to Half Dome. It's our second rainy day.
We have a
storm's coming in. You can see over here, Clouds Rest is over here, which we're not going to be able to make because of the storm, but we'll try to hit Half Dome tomorrow, which is right through these trees. Yes, you can see it well. Yep, just through the trees.
Her teeth, the white stones, at the edge of the water, the summer grasses. Her plentiful hair. We have a beautiful mother. Her green lap immense. Her brown embrace eternal. Her blue body.
Heading up to the cables. It's day 31. It's quite the climb up to this point. And that's the beginning of the cables.
Day 31. Heading up to the cables of Half Dome. There's Barbara, John's sister, right in front of me. John's off to the right. And a gentleman we met named Marty is right in the center with that yellow coat on. This is the cable we're gonna be climbing up. Day 31. We're up on top of Half Dome. We all made it safely. No tragedies. Looking down over
Yosemite Valley. Up and across. What's that rock there, John?
Glacier Point.
There's Glacier Point. We're coming around. All on the top of the big rock right now.
I know, right?
Looking out over.
On top of the trees in the background.
Beautiful scenery. Oh, there's Cloud's Rest right there. Beyond that gentleman. Quite a few people up here. It's a beautiful day.
Falls.
Videoing?
Yes, I am. Here comes Barb down this treacherous trail. Nevada Falls and the blue sky.
Picture you at the end, you know.
Myrtle Falls.